Welcome to the course on Test Your C Programming Skills, a guide to crack IT interview. Here we are starting discussion on fourth topic of this course, user-defined data types. And this is first session on structure basic concepts. Let's discuss some key points about user-defined data types. User-defined data types are useful to create own data types. Example of user-defined data types are structure, union, type dep, and enumeration. In this session, we are going to discuss structure in more details. Structure group related items together. Data type of these items may be same or different. This is example of using structure in C program. Struct student, then there are two members, role and name. And in main function, structure variable s is created. s.role is 10. Or there is another way of using structure. Student s1 is equal to in the bracket 20 and John. So structure definition is given by yellow rectangle. In structure definition, there are the structure members. So student structure is having two members, that is role and name. Student s, this instruction declares one structure variable. We can access member of that structure variable using dot operator by saying s.role. We can also do the initialization when we are declaring the variable. For example, student s1 is equal to 20 and John. Structure members cannot be initialized in structure definition. Memory is allocated only when structure variable is created. So that's why initialization in structure definition is not allowed. Let's discuss first example of this session. See the code carefully and guess the output. In the program, there is a structure student having two members, that is a role and marks. And in main function, structure variable s is created. And then there is a printf, which is displaying the value of structure members. So what will be the output of this program? And the correct answer is, this program displays the garbage values. Let's understand why we are getting garbage as output of this program. Note that structure variable s in this program is a local variable and it is having automatic storage class. Default value for local variables are garbage, and that's why we are getting garbage as the output for this program. Sometimes you may observe 0 as a default value, but in real sense they are a garbage. So the output of this program is garbage. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. Again, there is a struct student with two members, static int role and float marks. And in main function, structure variable is created, that is s, and then it is displaying the values of various members of structure variable s. So what will be the output of this program? And the correct answer is, this program gives the compiler error. Let's understand why we are getting compiler error for this program. Note that storage class is applicable to structure variable and it is not applicable to structure member. So there is a compiler error at line number 5 because here we are trying to apply static storage class on a structure member, which is not permitted. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. In the program, there is a struct student having two members, that is role and marks. And in main function, there is a structure variable s. There is a structure pointer sptr, which is pointing to variable s. And then the members of structure are given certain values. And in printf, these values are displayed. So what will be the output of this program? And the correct answer is, This program gives the output as 10, 71.2, 81.9 and 85.5. Let's understand why we are getting output like this. Note that SPTR is a pointer to structure and it is pointing to structure variable S. When we are accessing structure members using a pointer to structure, then arrow operator is useful. SPTR and S both are pointing to same content, and that's why the program displays these values, that is 10 for roll number, 71.2 for the marks 0, 81.9 for marks 1 and 80.5 for marks 2. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. There is a structure student declared, and in main function there is a array of structure variables, that is S2, and there is a structure pointer SPTR which is pointing to S, and then S0.roll is 10, S1.roll is 11, and then it is displaying various values of structure members. Correct answer of this question is, this program gives the output as a 10, 11 and 10. Let's understand why we are getting 10, 11 and 10 as an output. Here S is an array of structure variables. Array of structure variables work in a similar way like array of other data types. SPTR structure pointer is pointing to S0 structure element. So SPTR roll number is 11, whereas S0 roll number is 10, and that's why the output of this program is 10, 11 and 10. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. In the program there is a struct student with two members, that is a roll and marks. Then there is a bonus marks function which accepts one structure variable as argument. It increments the value of 0th marks by 10, and in main function structure variable S is initialized with various values, and then there is a call to function bonus marks, and then it is displaying various values of structure members of S structure variable. Correct answer of this program is, this program gives the output as a 10, 70.7, 55.6 and 67.2. So the values are exactly same which were there while initializing the structure variable S. After calling the bonus marks function, there is no change in the values of structure variable S. So let's understand why we are getting the output like this. Note that structure variable passed in the bonus marks function is passed using call by value method. If parameter is passed by using call by value method, then changes in the function are made on local copy, and these changes are not visible in main function. And that's why the bonus marks function, though it changes the marks 0, that changes are not visible in main function. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. There is a structure demo with 3 variables, that is X, Y, Z, and in a main function on line number 9 and 10 it is giving certain values to the members X, Y and Z, and then on line number 11 and 12 it is displaying the values of structure members for structure variable D1 and D2. So what will be the output of this program? And the correct answer is, this program gives the output as a 30, 10, 20, 20, 0 and 0. Let's understand why we are getting output like this. Note that this program, it is initializing structure members using designated initialization, and this type of initialization is valid. So on line number 9, dot y is equal to 10, it initializes the value of member y for D1 variable to 10, and in similar way it is initializing the value for structure member Z and X, And also on line number 10, it is initializing the value for structure member x for d2 variable. So this syntax is also correct to initialize the values for structure members, and that's why the output is 30, 10, 20, 20, 0, 0. So in the next part, we'll discuss about union and structure member alignment. Till then, enjoy C programming.